Good morning. Welcome to Immigration Wednesdays. I'm the attorney Jeff Peek with the law firm of Peek & Tolan. And today we're going to talk a little bit about expunctions and what are they. Also known as expungements, I've heard them used both ways. It's a process in the state of Texas whereby one who was charged with a criminal case, whether it be DWI, misdemeanor, felony, had that case either dismissed or they were found not guilty, can then erase that the presence of that case in all records, both physical, state, paper files, computer, digital, online, so that it doesn't appear anywhere. So we're going to talk a little bit about that, who's eligible and what the process is. So first of all, this is in the state of Texas. If you were arrested in another state, check with lawyers in that state, because a lot of states are very different in how they handle this. In Texas, you must have either had the case dismissed or be found not guilty at trial. Now, a dismissal, let's talk about that real quick. There's different types of dismissals, okay? Deferred adjudication, while technically a dismissal at the end of the case, does not qualify for an expunction. That's a different process called a motion to seal records. We'll probably talk about that another Wednesday, but that is not qualifying. We're talking about a dismissal that is what we would call in a lawyer language a straight dismissal, meaning there was no reduction of charges, there was no lesser punishment involved in that. It was completely the charges are dropped and that was it. For example, if you were charged with DWI and they agreed to dismiss the DWI, but then you had to plead to a reckless driving or obstruction of a passageway, you would not be able to expunge the DWI because you ended up taking a plea deal and a punishment on a lesser case, okay? Now, sometimes you find cases where somebody's charged with a misdemeanor or a felony and they drop it down to a different level and it's dismissed at that lower level. Well, like for instance, you have a felony dropped down to a misdemeanor, but then you got a deferred prosecution on the misdemeanor. Or they dropped it down to a Class C ticket and you got a deferred disposition on the Class C ticket that also ended up in dismissal. In some of those cases, you could still be eligible to expunge it. So if you have any question about that, you want to check with a lawyer. But again, it has to be a straight dismissal. Now, also, if you go to trial, whether in front of a jury or a judge, and you're found not guilty, you're also eligible to have expunged. And even better, you don't have to pay the filing fees for that, so that's a good bit of it. But very few people, statistically, go to trial and get found not guilty, so you're most likely to be eligible on the dismissal. What if you complete probation? Are you eligible for expunction? No. What if you finished a jail sentence and it's been more than 10 years, are you eligible for expunction? No. It's really very limited to those two classes of people, okay? And again, if you have a deferred adjudication, there's another process. Secondly, why would you want to do it? Well, there's a lot of reasons, obviously. You know, employers have access to criminal records. They may see that you were arrested and may not like the fact that you were charged something, even if you got off on the case. It could be you're dating somebody and you don't want the family of your girlfriend or your fiance to see your record. It could be for potentially that you want to apply for law enforcement or you want to go to some career where this might haunt you. That might also help. There's also two important reasons from an immigration side and just from a criminal defense side, honestly. So for an immigration side, for example, there's a lot of programs now, really great programs, both here in Central Texas and many other counties, where you can enter what's called a deferred prosecution agreement, or sometimes it's called a pretrial diversion agreement. There's also things called drug courts. There are various programs where if you do the requirements they ask you to, which sometimes almost feel like a probation, you have to do some classes, maybe you have to come to court a few times, maybe you have to report with somebody, but if you get through all the requirements after a year, year and a half, 2 years, they will actually dismiss the case. Sometimes they dismiss it on the front end, sometimes on the back end, but it's a true dismissal that you're eligible to expunge. Well, for immigration law, USCIS, which is United States Citizen Immigration Services, has begun to call into question whether that dismissal is actually a true dismissal, and they've actually said, hey, no, that's not a true dismissal. You admitted to doing that when you signed that deferred prosecution agreement. You made a confession of statements, or when you participated in that pretrial diversion program or that drug court, you went in front of a judge and admitted that you actually did those activities. You took responsibility. Immigration saying, that's not a dismissal. We're gonna count that as a conviction. And even if you have the paperwork showing the dismissal, they will still argue with you and say, nope, we know those programs required a confession or acknowledgement of responsibility, therefore you are guilty of those charges. So it's become, and this is relatively new in the last couple of years, so it's very important when you dismiss those, all those records that they would rely on, that immigration would try to use to say and make that point that you were really guilty, they're destroyed, they're gone, immigration won't even know about them. Now, would you have to still admit that you had the arrest? Sure. But then you could say you were dismissed, they wouldn't know how. So that's one huge reason why to do it. That's kind of a technical area. If you're an immigrant or somebody with permanent residency or family member and you are in that situation, definitely talk to a lawyer who knows both criminal defense and immigration law so you make sure you understand why they're recommending that. But that's one huge reason why you'd want to do it. Secondly, if you were charged, I don't know why I pointed not guilty, but secondly, if you were in a criminal case, let's say you got a DWI, and this actually just recently happened with a client of mine, and we were able to get his DWI dismissed. It was years ago. Fast forward 3 years later, he gets picked up on another DWI. Amazingly, our lawyers do a great job and get that DWI dismissed. He's now picked up a third time. Now, first of all, I know what you're thinking. Man, this guy's got a drinking problem. I hope he doesn't get off of it. I understand your point there. But he gets picked up on a third DWI. Well, he never expunged the previous two DWIs. And now he's in front of a prosecutor who can look at his record and say, oh, well, this is not the first, this is not the second, this is the third. In fact, and it's just by nature, a prosecutor is never going to think that somebody was 100% innocent when they got the charges dropped. They're going to assume they had a good lawyer, or they made a good plea deal, or there's some technicality they may have got off of. So now you have a prosecutor sees this guy's broken the law in his mind three times and got off of it twice. He's going to be ready to hammer him. And how hard is it going to be for that defense lawyer to go in there and try to get him to drop a third charge or drop it down to an obstruction or reckless? You know, it's going to be very difficult, pretty much forcing the position where that client's going to have to take that case to trial and hope he wins, or, you know, potentially be on probation or jail. So imagine if that same client who already had been arrested twice before filed the expunctions to erase those cases, he gets into court and that prosecutor now, oh, this is the first time, he thinks it's the first time DWI case. It gives an incredible amount of leverage to your defense attorney to possibly push for a better result. So those are two examples where it's going to help you in real life. I see it all the time. And a lot of people, I understand, just they don't take the initiative to do it. So I hope you take the initiative to do it, clean your record, and hopefully it'll go well for you both in law, in life, in love, and employment, all those areas, okay? I hope that's been some help for you today. My name's Jeff Peek again with Peek & Tolan Law Firm. If you need any help with expunctions, please call us. We'd be happy to help. We'll see you next Wednesday.